Hello, yeah, welcome back to the class. Yeah, welcome back to the class on Grand Skills International. So, we'll be going on to our next class on effective management of fish farming. So, having known all this, let us go to the next episode. And that is character one. We'll be dealing on character one. Character one is fishery aquaculture. When we talk about aquaculture, what do we mean? Aquaculture is the study and production of fish, shrimps, and other aquatic animals. So when we talk of aquaculture, we are not talking only about fish. But in this course, we are training on fish alone. We are training on Clara's species of catfish and tilapia, okay? So fish is the most important of all the living resources of the sea. It's an aquatic vertebrate that typically breathes by the means of gills and moves by means of fins. Those are pectoral and canal. They are cold-blooded animals. Example, their body temperature is regulated by their environment. They can be found throughout the world's fresh, blackish, and brackish water. When you talk about fresh water, we talk about streams, we talk about blackish water, we talk about other streams too. There are streams that are like blackish in color. If you look at the water, the depth seems blackish. If you also talk about brackish water, it's also fresh water. Fish has long played an important part in man's economy, becoming increasingly important since the world's population has grown. Wow, this is the most interesting part of it. That is why I say, even if you have 1 million fish in your farm, if you have 1 million fish in your farm, believe me, you can sell them off in just 3 days to 1 week, okay? Because the demand for fish is so massive, is so massive, okay? Attempts have been made over the years to increase the yield of fishes to help meet the needs of the world's ever-increasing population. No matter the amount of fish you have in your farm, you can never meet the demand of the market. You can never meet the demand of the market, except those that does not know what they are doing. I do the practicals. We have done so many supplies, so we know what is in the market. No matter the number of fish you have, with my clients, I supply fishes to clients, and I supply fishes to the market. I buy from several clients. I harvest their farms, so I've known the ins and outs of the market. The market is so big. Okay. The food potentials of the sea and how to propagate them is attracting increasing attention. That is the reason you came to acquire this course, because the food potentials of the sea and how to propagate them is attracting increasing attention. So these potentials is what attracts you to acquire this professional course. The more obvious reason for the interest of fisheries is the assumption based on economic consideration in terms of cost, that it is cheaper to buy fish than meat. Yeah, it is cheaper to buy fish than meat. And based on doctors' advice for people to eat more of fish than meat due to the cholesterol content in meat, which cannot be found in fish, okay? Especially tilapia, okay? So, fish has played a moderate role and important part of man's food supply. They are major food sources valuable for the protein they provide, and also a source of industrial products. So many industries use food, use fish, fish scale, fish offal, and so on, fish bone to produce so many things. Okay, fish is the most important source of animal protein for human, and many fishes are used as food. Subsidiary uses of fish and fish scraps, the extract of fish liver oils as one of the source for vitamin D, and manufacturing of pet food. Fish scales are sometimes used in making artificial pear icing glass. A form of gelatin is prepared from the swim bladder of a certain species, and glue can be made from fish offal. The resources, once thought as unlimited, is now realized to be quite finite and in delicate balance with biological, chemical, and physical factor of the aquatic environment. Okay? Importance of fishery. Importance of fish. What is the importance of fishes? Now you are acquiring the course, you want to be a professional fish farmer, you want to or you want to have a fish farm, but you want to have the knowledge, and then you have some people working for you, or you have in mind that, oh, this fish farming, you want to have it in a very extensive scale, in a very large scale. So you want to know more about the fish before embarking on such project. So what is the importance of it? Number one, it serves as a rich source of food by supplying protein. Okay? The selling of fish and fish products can generate income to the fish farmers. Selling of fish and fish products can generate income. Okay? You can sell fish products to generate income. It provides foreign exchange for a country like the Scandinavian countries of Norway, Denmark, and Sweden, who rely on fish and fish products. So if you are exporting fish, you're a billionaire. Number four, fish and fish products can be processed into fish meal for feeding animals. Five, it is a good source of employment, be it direct fishing or allied industries. It puts our water and land into a better use. This is so great. This is so great. No matter the size of the land, you can use it for fish. No matter where the land is, no matter the space you have, no matter how little or how big, you can use it for fish. An uncompleted building can be converted to fish farm. A soakaway pit can be converted to fish farm, meaning the one you've not used before. You can use it for fish farm before you start using it. Maybe after, when you have made your money and you don't want to use it for farm, and then you can move the farm to another place and use the sock away for your house. Okay. Number seven, fish can also help us to recycle our domestic waste. It provides good form of educational activities for students and researchers. Students will always come to your farm for IT. People will always come to your farm for research. The kids will always come for tourists, for so many of them. So, nine, fish can also help to increase the dietary protein requirements at a very cheap cost in areas where animal protein may be high to purchase. It generates a good source of financial income. Okay. We'll be coming back to take terminologies in fishery. Thank you for staying tuned on the class.